Well, good afternoon, everybody. It's lovely to have you with us. And greetings to if you're joining us on YouTube. You're very welcome too. My name's Pippa, and I'm one of the visiting chaplains here at Crowhurst. Shall we open in prayer? Father, thank you so much that you promise that where two or three gather in your name, you are there amongst them. So we welcome you, Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, move amongst us. Just be powerfully present. Help us to worship in spirit and in truth. Come, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Our theme for today is engraved on the palms of his hands. You might be familiar with the passage in Isaiah where this is from, and I'll read that shortly. The context is that the Israelites were in exile in Babylon, and they were in great distress because they felt that God had forgotten them. They were so discouraged that they cried out, "The Lord has forsaken us." However, Isaiah points out that God could never forget them, just as a loving mother could not forget her child. So let's hear Isaiah 49, beginning to read at verse 13. Shout for joy, you heavens. Rejoice, you earth. Burst into song, you mountains. For the Lord comforts his people and will have compassion on his afflicted ones. But Zion said, "The Lord has forsaken me. The Lord has forgotten me." Can a mother forget the baby at her breast and have no compassion on the child she has borne? Though she may forget, I will not forget you. See, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are ever before me. When I prayed about what our theme might be today, I was reminded of that passage, and in particular, verse 16. So I chose engraved on the palms of his hands. They're beautiful words of hope and promise. Then, as I thought about what God might want to say to us, I began to wonder why he did it. Why exactly did he engrave us on the palms of his hands? And as I prayed, I felt God was showing me three reasons why. And we're going to have a look at them and do some humming as well. The first reason is permanence. It's permanent. We're not talking about something fleeting that could be erased over time, because engraved means to cut into and to carve. It will never and can never be undone. Do come in and join us. It's not just a tattoo on God's hand written with ink that could gradually fade over time. We're engraved on his hands as eternal reminders. As you may know, in ancient times, a slave would be branded with the seal of his master, so everyone knew which slave belonged to which master. This is the other way around. The master brands the servant's names, our names, into himself. It's utterly permanent. Let's pause and enjoy our first hymn, which specifically mentions our theme in the first verse. It's Before the Throne of God Above. Thank you, Stephen. So we've looked at permanence as one reason why God engraves our names. The second reason is that it's a sign. First of all, it's a sign to us. The Lord gives us a picture or an image to help us understand. It can encourage us that not only has he not forgotten us, but he cannot forget us. Sadly, we often forget God, and then we tend to think he's like us. But he's not. No matter how much we fail him or sin against him or choose our way over his, there is no change in his love towards us. He doesn't erase our names from the palms of his hands on the basis of our disobedience or thoughtlessness. No, we're safe in the permanence of his love. This passage is a great word for when we're feeling discouraged or forgotten. So let's allow it to be a comfort to us. The engravings are assigned to us, but they're also assigned to others. The Lord chose us before the foundation of the world. and the engravings testify to that covenant in the heavenly realms. They say, "This is a child of the Most High God." In Revelation 5, verse 6, St. John tells us, "I saw a lamb looking as if it had been slain, standing at the center of the throne." Those scars are immortal marks of love throughout eternity. And so are our names written on his palms. And finally, if I may be so bold, it's a sign to himself. Of course, I'm not suggesting that the Lord is forgetful, but he chooses to carry a permanent and powerful sign of each one of us etched into himself. Let's pause again and enjoy a reflective tese chant, Ubi Caritas. If you remember, I said that I felt God had shown me three reasons why he engraved us on the palms of his hands, though I'm sure you may be able to think of more. The third reason is that it's a declaration of love. God wants us to know, without a shadow of a doubt, how much he loves us. Isaiah 49, verse 16, gives us a tender look at those hands of divine love which tell us he will never leave us or forsake us. I came across one writer with an amazing name, Augustus Toplady. Augustus Toplady. And he called the engravings marks of indelible grace. And I love that, marks of indelible grace. Another writer called it an aggressive act of God, displaying his love. And that word aggressive does give us a sense of God the Father carving us into himself. And it did make me think too of God the Son, who received the wounds of the nail holes into his hands. And those nail-pierced hands also send us declaration of love, telling us that the Lord will always cherish those for whom he suffered and died. So we're engraved on the palms of God's hands because it's permanent. It's a sign to us, to others, and God himself. And it's a declaration of love. You are God's beloved and precious child. So let that truth encourage your heart. Let's have a few moments of quiet. Let's pray. Father, you chose us before time began, and you engraved us on the palms of your hands because you love us unconditionally. Lord, I ask that you would plant that truth deep within each heart. As the carol says, O come to us, abide with us, be born in us today. And Lord, if there's anyone who is uncertain of your love or is feeling discouraged or forgotten, would you minister to them, Lord? Renew them with your Holy Spirit and grant them a new assurance that you love them. Not dependent on how they feel or what they may have done. May we celebrate your birth again this Christmas, Lord, and look forward to all you want to do in our lives. In Jesus' name, Amen. So let's have our final hymn. And it's that beautiful hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. So it's going to be very hard not to sing, but we can sing in our hearts. So as we close, if you'd like someone to come alongside you in prayer, just approach one of the chaplains. One of us will be on duty in the quiet lounge and in and around Howard's Well. So do come and avail yourself of prayer if you'd like to. And I do wish you all a very, very happy Christmas. God bless you. Amen. Thank you.